Right, so I'm snowed in. We're reviewing Iridescence on the Record Club for the podcast this week, so I wanted to create something that would run through my thoughts on each of their other records in a more tight, succinct way, since this is from a band that means a lot to me. So here's that.
Smoking like 5-6 blunts in this bitch.
Brockhampton are a collective and self-described boy band that all met on the internet through a Kanye West fan forum consisting of 14 official members that include musicians, graphic designers, producers, and multimedia artists of all kind. The main frontmen of the group are Kevin Abstract, Don McLennan, Merlin Wood, Bareface, Joba aka Russell Boring, Matt Champion, and formerly Amir Van. After getting together and creating a mixtape by the name of All American Trash, which was kind of unremarkable and bland but showed promise, in 2017 the group all got together in one house in southern central California where they pooled all their collective talent into creating three albums in the span of just a few months, later known as the Saturation Trilogy, the title of which alluding to the goal of the project, which was to saturate the music industry with their music as much as possible by creating projects of considerable density and length. The albums went on to be highly successful and acclaimed and beloved by many and ultimately landed them a record deal with RCA. Saturation 1 is a step up from their original mixtape in every conceivable way. The beats, courtesy of excellent producers on the Brockhampton team, are hard-hitting, creative, dynamic, and somehow perfectly capture the wavelength of hip-hop, alt-R&B, and pop music at the time, drawing inspiration from musicians like Kanye West, Frank Ocean, Outkast, 90s boy bands, and occasionally even rock music, specifically born from the grunge era like Smashing Pumpkins and Nirvana, which allowed their music to perfectly catch on. Despite the amount of both people involved and the eclectic nature of this project as a whole, all three Saturation albums both have consistency and a singular identity that makes them unique and interesting in and of themselves. What separates Saturation 1 from its two sister albums is, primarily, how spacious and dreamy it is. While the album leads off with its incredibly hard-hitting and pop-oriented singles, like the blisteringly brutal Heat and the insanely catchy Gold, and fun, upbeat, bouncy songs like Star, once it hits its stride, it serves to be something more akin to a shoegaze album by way of contemporary hip-hop. Again, there's a lot of Frank Ocean influence here. The album also contains several minute-long tracks that act as brief digressions and singular moments, like Tupac, that contain a surprising amount of emotional depth. A lot of what makes Brockhampton Brockhampton is demonstrated beautifully on this record, as the boys tapped into a lot of issues facing contemporary lower-to-middle-class youth. Music in question is really goddamn fun and upbeat, but it's always rooted in relatability, covering topics like friendship, the uncertainty of the future, mental health, relationships, depression, feeling lost, and general youthful ennui, which is why I think it caught on the way it did, because it was idiosyncratically designed to engage with an audience that clearly already existed and was ready for something like it. Saturation 1, despite being the most laid-back Brockhampton album, has energy and production that makes it consistently exciting and engaging, even if it can take a bit properly to warm up to. I know when I first heard it, I largely didn't know what to make of it, but it grew on me as I settled into the vibe of the record and was able to digest it more holistically. It's worth noting that this record has its moments of genuine, profound, and lyrically masterful moments, which is no better exemplified than on the song Milk, a song where the members lyrically vent their frustrations about where they are in life and how they only need friends because of how frightening life is. Don McLennan's final verse here might be my favorite verse in the entire genre of hip-hop, as I find it emotional, raw, insightful, and deeply poetic. Saturation 1 also really lets you acclimate to the personalities of Brockhampton, letting you grow accustomed to their individual styles and characters in a very endearing way. Dom is the resident poet, Joba is the delightfully quirky and unhinged cartoon character, Merlin Wood is horny, Amir Van is both a facsimile of traditional hip-hop stereotypes with a vulnerable edge, Matt Champion is sad and sleepy, Bareface sings like an angel about forlorn relationships, and Kevin is gay. Despite containing a lot of darker and even socially incisive moments where they tackle topics like isolation and racial discrimination, the album is full of fun hooks and goofy humor that make it endearing from start to finish. The album ends off like every Saturation album ends, with a ballad performed by Bareface that blossoms into a beautiful and show-stopping finish for a record that ebbs and flows between a summery daydream and channeling a long car ride with your friends where you plug in the aux and sing along to all your favorite sad boy anthems. All things considered, I think Saturation 1 is a stunning debut record that is designed flawlessly to get you into Brockhampton's music, containing all of their appeal without sacrificing its own artistic integrity, and it's one of the most creative, interesting, inspiring, funny, personal, emotional, and genuinely beautiful projects of the 2010s, due to it being very evidently made by a group of friends who all genuinely love making art and music, and the Saturation albums stand as a testament to the DIY, millennial, Gen Z celebration of emotionally honest and homegrown art. If I have any complaints, it's really mostly in the skits, of which there are three here. They're all short, thankfully, and the transition between the three parts of the album is pretty well handled, but in and of themselves, they add virtually nothing musically and have no real ideas behind them, and generally I think the pacing would be improved without them. But still, it's hard to complain when literally every song is still so great. Very small complaint, but yeah, it's there. 9 out of 10. Good album.